Hello and welcome to Film 24. Mark Kermode is at the Cannes Film Festival. I'm in Shepherd's Bush. But Mark has the news of this week's best films and releases. Mark.
Hello, Gavin. Yes, I join you from the madness of the Cannes Film Festival. We're overlooking the Croisette, the main Lumiere Theatre is behind me with the famous Cannes red carpet. As you can probably hear, it's incredibly noisy. The movies we're going to be looking at this week, Robin Hood, the new movie by Ridley Scott, American, the Bill Hicks story, a documentary about the American comedian, and Lebanon, the award-winning Israeli film.
Tell us about Bill Hicks. I mean, the American stand-up comedian. This is a documentary about him.
It's a documentary about the life of Bill Hicks, who was recently voted the fourth greatest comedian of all time here in England. Amazingly enough, in America, he's still nothing like as well-known as perhaps he should be. This is a documentary tracing his career from his very, very early years. Let's see a clip.
He went to the Just for Laughs Festival in Montreal. Just for Laughs is like the Cannes Film Festival for comedy. They come from all over the world, and it's a big deal.
He realized for the first time in Canada there was a new boundary and far more thirst for his perspective about what was going on with the American dream.
First of all, this needs to be said. There never was a war.
How can you say that, Bill?
Well, a war is when two armies are fighting. So you see, right there, I think we can all agree.
Here he was, not only just playing in the arena of international comedy, he was excelling in that arena.
I guess the question is this about Bill Hicks the man, the kind of rounded man, or is this a lot of his stand-up gags with a few interviews in between?
No, actually, it's the former. There is really not so much of his stand-up routines. Occasionally, I have to say, I mean, as somebody who was a great fan of Bill Hicks, I would see a clip of the stand-up routines, and I just want to watch the whole of the rest of the routine. What the documentary gives you is something else. It gives you a very thorough investigation into his life. There's an amazing amount of footage of him, particularly from an early age. His father seemed to make films very, very early on. There's some evidence of some very early slapstick films that he made with his, you know, comedy friends. We have the whole sweep of his career very fully documented. All first-hand interviews, people talking about things that they remember themselves. They've also done a very good job of taking photographs and animating the photographs to give the impression that what you're getting is moving footage from the early years. I found this a very engrossing piece of work, particularly since so much of Bill Hicks' comedy was edgy, was dangerous, was borderline obscene, and yet what we see here is a very warm relationship with his family, who turn out to be thoroughly supportive of him. I thought it was a very fine piece of work and didn't just fall into what you suggested quite rightly, because it's something we've seen before, of just replaying clips from somebody's act.
And I think this is also something we talked about before. The documentary is back. I mean, documentaries, some of the most interesting movies of the past 5 years have been documentaries.
Yeah, and don't forget, of course, that, you know, in the not-too-distant past, that Michael Moore won the Palme d'Or here at Cannes with Fahrenheit 9/11. I have to say, I think it was an unjustified win, but it was certainly a demonstration of the fact that documentaries are back in full force. If you get a chance to see American, the Bill Hicks story, in a cinema, do check it out.